that we're streaming right now. I think we are. Looks like success on my end. And you guys just caught me right here in the middle of, oh, who knew it, cooking up some bacon. And you know what this is going to be for? This is going to be for, well, check out what we have out right now. We have out waffle maker. So I'm going to be making waffle BLT. We're just finishing off some bacon right now. We already got some bacon cooked up here, obviously. I didn't want to waste all your guys' time watching me cook bacon. I thought that'd be kind of boring. We're just going to left dash and get this done, and we'll move on to making these savory waffles. And one of the things I want to do with these waffles is that they're not going to be traditional waffles. I don't like me a sweet-ass waffle. I like a waffle that's got a savoriness to it. And instead, like, waffles traditionally, you put sugar in them. No, that's not happening. No sugar going to be in these waffles. Waffles traditionally usually have, like, vanilla in them. And we're not going to have vanilla in these either. But we are going to have, instead of, usually waffles also usually have butter in them. No, we're going to use this bacon fat right here. Use this delicious, delicious bacon fat. And we're going to add in a whole bunch of herbs that I had left over from a lamb dish that Sammy Girl and I did. And I'm going to add mainly rosemary and probably some sage and a little bit of thyme. And some cracked pepper, of course, maybe a touch of garlic. These are going to be some savory-ass waffles, and I'm very excited about it. First, let's get this bacon done. I'm going to turn up the heat a little bit. I'm trying to, like, accelerate the process, but I also don't want to splatter oil all over my countertop. And I am using a book to prop up this camera over here. And I was like, oh, maybe I shouldn't splash oil all over it, but this guy is now an accused rapist. So I'm like, I was going to throw the book out, but I really like some of the recipes. I don't really know what to do with it. It's like listening to a Chris Brown album. You're like, oh, I like the music, but it might be a piece of shit. It's hard. Although I don't watch Bill Cosby shit anymore, because you just can't separate the two. Hey, everybody in the chat. Thanks for watching. I appreciate it. This bacon needs to be flipped. Maybe in a second. Oh, I turned the heat up too high. That bubbling
starts down. Gotta watch the
flame. Make sure I don't turn it off. If you guys were watching last night, you know that this little portable gas stovetop here I'm using gets extremely hot. Way hotter than your normal stovetop. But for some reason, it has a little dial on this side. Can I get this to come over that far? Has a little dial on this side, and if you turn it too far, oh, it's barely on. That's barely on, and off is down here. It turns off right in here, and then just like leaks gas out. So you gotta be very careful. And then high is insane. It's way too hot. Let's get a little bit. This cast iron's already been heated up from being on my stovetop, so. Maybe it's time to flip Philadelphia. Oh yeah, there we go. Look at that, it's looking so good. Or at least the ones in the center. Oh no. There we go. That little guy curled up on the side. That's alright, he'll be fine. Flip the rest in a minute. I'll do another gaming video at some point. Probably tomorrow, maybe. We're gonna have some snow days out here in New York, so I'm gonna be bored. I got some work to do, but you know, you can only do so much. What are you guys having for dinner? Let me know in the chat. I would love to see, love to know. Ooh, it's splashing oil in my face right now. That's what's gonna happen, huh? Alright, calm down. Time to flip, I think, again. how much oil we got in here that we're going to use. Save up this bacon fat. It's very useful. Sometimes I'll like make an egg sandwich and I don't have bacon, but I just cook the egg in a tiny bit of bacon fat. And it makes it taste like there's bacon in there, even if the texture isn't there. It's still very, very nice. Ooh, chicken, broccoli, and asparagus. Jordan, that sounds delicious. How are you cooking that, though? Is that just like a chicken breast? Or is it like a stew? Is there cheese involved? Because I want there to be cheese involved. The Goon, why do you not know what you're eating for dinner yet? I mean, you could be in a different time zone, because right now it's 8:39 p.m. here in New York City, so... I gotta know what I'm eating for dinner, because it is dinner time. It's past, or I guess it depends on how old you are, if it's dinner time or not. If you're still in your 20s, dinner time can go to midnight. If you're in your 30s, maybe 8 p.m. Maybe 9 p.m. It depends on social circles, lifestyle. I remember when I first moved here, I had a friend who had lived here like for a couple years before, and I was, you know, like 20, 21 years old, and so I thought that she was the shit and knew everything about New York, and she's like, oh no, you can't go out for dinner before 9 p.m., it's not cool, and I, like, took her word for it, and I'm like, no, I'll go out for dinner at 5, it's amazing, because you can sit down, there's no one else there in your way, you don't have to wait that long for your food or your drinks, it's fantastic, I don't have to wait to eat with the cool kids, fuck the cool kids, eat when I want. Not that I go out that often. Timmy Girl and I might start going out more often though. Because she's moving in on May 8th. Woo! I'm very excited. How long does this usually take? Cooking bacon? I mean, we're all done with this stuff. Kim? And then I gotta mix, I'm going from scratch on the waffles. Oh wow. So that'll be a minute. But I'm only gonna cook a couple batches of waffles. I'll cook the rest off camera, because I don't wanna make you guys wait through all that. Speaking of which, while these are finishing up, I'm just gonna turn around and I'm going to start the oven on a very low heat setting, because after the waffles come out of the waffle maker, I'll be putting them into the oven to dry out for a little bit, because I like them to get extra crispy, and actually my favorite way to have them is I make a ton, and I freeze them. Oh, sorry guys, I was just checking something. Sorry about the break, guys. One of my cameras goes down periodically. C'est la vie. But the bacon's about done. I got the oven turned on to help dry out my waffles so that I can have them nice and crispy. I was just saying how I like to make a bunch, freeze them, and then toast them later. They get extra crispy. I'm just gonna set this all on this plate right here so these can all dry out and not be too oily for a sandwich later. I'm gonna set that to the side back here. Let's go ahead and get this hot stuff out of the way. Gotta use pan holders. And have that oil ready for later. I'm gonna disconnect this gas right here so we aren't going to cause any explosion. Except I should have done it the other way first. Shit, did not think of that. That's my bad. Almost died. Almost died. Woo. Always disconnect the can before you disconnect it from where it's going. Stupid me. I'll put this somewhere safe. Be right back, guys. mix up our dough, or our batter, I guess, more for a waffle. So here we got our waffle iron. But first, oh, we got a long comment here. I'm cooking some patties, toasting the buns, making homemade secret sauce, and some perfect golden edges corn cakes. Drinking, I mean, simply yet healthy and delicious non-alcoholic pina colada. Good for you. That sounds very fun. Okay, so we're going to start here. Got flour. We're going to need baking soda, baking powder, and egg. Let's start with our wet ingredients. We need 2 eggs. Because we're about to put in some buttermilk. Measuring cup. Buttermilk is in the fridge. Check it out. And we need 1 3/4 cup of buttermilk. Oh, so thick. Just smelling it, I was like, damn, that's some chunky ass buttermilk, but I guess that's the way it's supposed to be. And the oven is ready. Look at that, it looks so good. Now we need 1/2 cup of oil. And since we're gonna use bacon fat here, we're gonna use this as an additional step. We're not gonna add any salt to the rest of the dish. Let's check this out. There you go, now you can see me pour in this oil here. Hopefully this will be enough. I got some more I can melt up though. Well, I can't see the markings, but this will be fine. Oh yeah, that's enough. That's 1/2 cup, that's a little bit more than 1/2 cup. These are gonna be some bacony waffles. You can drink buttermilk if you want. Wolfie Boo? Yeah. You can drink it if you like, but I would not suggest it. It doesn't. It's like just very tangy, thick milk. So now all we got to do is whisk this all together. If you were making sweet ones, you would add in vanilla at this point. You want to get all the liquid ingredients together. But we ain't doing that though. We keeping it salty. Oh, Sammy Girl's texting me. What's up, Sammy Girl? Keep whisking. I might have to add another egg though because I added too much oil. The egg is used to incorporate the oil. Up. Here we go, fam. That's so good. That's better. All nice and incorporated. Data, it's not cooking it. It's fine. It's gonna be okay. I thought about that too. Y'all need to relax. Hey Pickles, how you doing? Okay, I gotta text Sammy real back though. There we go. Okay. So now we're getting to dry ingredient time. And done with that measuring. We are going to need flour. And we are going to need, I think it's, what, 2 cups? Oh, it's, 2 cups of flour. Okay. Let's do this. Where did I put this? Got my half measuring cup. My other one's dirty. Uno. Dos. Tres. Cuatro. Here. Now we need to add our baking soda and baking powder. So we need 2 teaspoons of baking powder. There we go. Uno. Dos. This is to help it rise and get nice and fluffy. And 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Here we go. Perfecto. Stir this up a little bit. Ooh, Doom Buggy, your mother has good taste. Those are great containers. I was worried when I bought them because they're really fucking expensive, but they're worth it. They're mad worth it. I use them for a lot of shit. Come on, I'm glad you like the ASMR radio, Doom Buggy. Appreciate it. Okay, I might make this a little bit more liquidy. Add some more buttermilk, because there's 1 secret ingredient I'm gonna add in a second. It's not that secret. I think I announced it in the text of the stream already. I just need this to be like a nice pourable mixture. And we're going to add my homemade sourdough. Guys, look at this. Look at this delicious sourdough. Ooh. I've been growing this out in my kitchen for like a few months. I love this. Oh, it smells suddenly just like alcohol and tanginess. And I'm just gonna get me a nice... Sure, I got a scooper. I got a scooper right here. Need a ladle. There's no ladle in some sourdough. Yeah. Get down on it. Get down on it. Get the nice yeastiness. Okay, that's probably more than enough. That might actually fuck it up. We'll see. Go grill, drip. Drip, drip, drip. Okay, sourdough, I'm gonna make pizza with you or something later, but I gotta put you away for now. Damn, you're growing big. God, I've been feeding you. Flour? Yeah, flour and water. That is what I've been feeding you. So now what we're going to do is we're going to chop up a few extra ingredients and add it in. First we got some kind of old-ass rosemary that I need to get rid of. Break that up, rub it up. Oh yeah. Get this all in here. Love me some rosemary. Even if it is a little bit old and dried out, that's okay. Still tastes good. And then we got some thyme. I'm gonna put a little bit of thyme in here. Good enough. Throw that away. And some sage. Get some good leaves like this sage. Throw all this away. And we're gonna crack some pepper. Shit, y'all. Gonna be some savory waffles. Some tangy savory waffles. And some more pepper. Oh, JJ, you see what Doom Buggy Jones says? Probably not, because I think you're on your phone, but... Okay, let me... I just need to see if this needs any salt or not. Maybe the tiniest bit. Oh, look how alive this dough is, though. It's all bubbling. That's because we got all that baking powder. And we got that baking soda. The yeast would not be working that fast, I don't think. But this means, I hope, that we're going to have a nice light texture, a light crumb, as they would say, when we heat it up. In fact, I should probably plug in the waffle iron. Get that preheating. And I'm gonna add it. Should I just try it? No, I'll need cooking spray on the waffle iron just to make sure it doesn't stick on the first batch. And another thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the waffle iron on top of this cord. Is not quite long enough. On top of this cutting board here so we're not leaking stuff all over my countertop. Just to make sure that they don't stick on the first batch. Should be fine after that. Alright, we gotta let that preheat for a second. What are you guys' favorite foods? Let me know. I should do a chicken wing ASMR. I think I have, but I want to make some homemade chicken wings and do it again because I love chicken wings. when I need to get a ladle. Not a ladle, I need to get a more of what a soup thingy. A ladle. A scoopy thing. Scoopy thing. Whew. You guys would not believe what I saw in the park today. I was out walking in Prospect Park, and I saw this dude, like, under a bridge abutment, like a pedestrian bridge thing, like, made out of stone in the woods. Very pretty. But he was just down to his underwear. I mean, he had, like, full, like, top weather gear on, face mask, and a baby carriage next to him. And he was squatting, and he just had his underwear on, and the thing, like, did you just finish a poop and you pulled up your underwear, maybe? The thing was, he was only, like, 2-3 minutes away from a public bathroom. And he didn't look like a homeless person. He looked like, you know, well-to-do. It was very confusing. But I saw him, and he looked at me. And I was like, turned, caught my eye, and then he quickly looks away, you know, ashamed. And I just kind of smiled and laughed and kept going. But this is the second time I've seen someone, like, openly pooping in the park in the past week. A few days ago, I saw a woman just in the middle of a field. And this is a lady, though. She's there every day. This is more sad. Like, she's always there every day at the same time. In the summer, sometimes she just strips down to her underwear. But that day, I saw her. It was a winter day. It's very cold. She just walked over to the tree stump where she usually hangs out, pulled down her pants, squatted, and just started shitting. And then the day after that, I saw her there again, and she was just waving at, like, her park friends, being like, oh, hey, good to see you. It's crazy, y'all. It's crazy out here. Aw, Caden, you just itching to get banned. I'm sorry. Aw, you banned. Damn, a set. Man, we have to wait a minute for this to preheat. You guys know how waffle makers work. They just, like, show you a little light. But as long as the light is on the waffle maker, like, that means it's heating up. There we go, upside down. And when it turns off, then it's hot enough to put the waffles in. And here we go. Come on, waffle maker. I'm really hoping these waffles turn out. I'm nervous. If they don't turn out, I'll just, like, turn off the stream. Yeah, text Sandra girl back. What will she say? I should have started this preheating before. I'm sorry, guys. This is the boring part of the stream. Do you guys see that there's going to be a huge storm named Toby hitting the east coast of the U.S.? I'm not excited about it. Mm-mm. I don't need no more snow and rain. But they say, like, up. This morning I woke up and were saying, like, a foot to 16 inches. I don't need no foot. I don't need no 16 inches of snow. I want none of that. Ooh, dude, but you're right. I love Korean fried chicken. I've been meaning to take Sam Rigger a lot to a Korean fried chicken place. It's actually a chain. Have you ever heard of Banchan Chicken? It's so good. I love it. There's a few here. There's, like, two here in New York. I think they're opening another one in Brooklyn soon, just, like, a mile from where I live. So we might just, like, walk down there. It's also on the way to and from, like, a movie theater we like to go to, so we might check that out soon. I think it's opening this summer. Very excited, because Korean fried chicken is one of my favorite things in the world. I have tried, like, Asian-inspired fried chickens here at home. The main thing being that you add... here we go. I got it right here. You got cornstarch. And the cornstarch helps you get, like, an extra crispy crust. It is very nice. Hello, Italy. Thank you for watching. We're just waiting on... Ooh, waffle maker to heat up right now. And it's taking forever. But that's okay. Ooh, I'm gonna get out. If I can find it.
Samir, where do you put the stuff?
Oh, there it is. The cooling rack. I'm gonna put some waffles on there as they become done. If they work out. I'm gonna add a little bit of garlic to this while we wait. Just a little garlic powder. Because I love garlic. Jordan, I'm sure you know how to cook great. Nothing I do is that complicated, you know? And you can learn anything if you just Google it. Come on, waffle maker, it doesn't shouldn't take this long to heat up. The waiting, and why I like to film these videos and not do them live, because it's less pressure and then I get to edit out all these long pauses like this. Your recipe to coat your chicken dune buggy is ketchup, mustard, mayo, barbecue honey, and mild mix. All that together? Ketchup, mustard, mayo, and hot sauce, and barbecue honey sauce. But do you mean like after you've cooked your chicken? And how are you cooking it? I don't know about this, it sounds crazy to me. Okay, we preheated, guys, get excited. We about to go in on this. Let's open it up. Look at all that. I'm glad I took the smoke detector down. That was probably fucking too much. We'll see. We'll see. Okay, now we just gotta wait again. I picked a weird food to live stream that involves so much waiting, didn't I? Yeah, that's on me. That's my bad. So now the light should turn on again when it gets colder from the cold mix hitting the metal. And then when it turns off, yeah, there we go. Okay, I was nervous because the light was not turning on. And I was like, did I not put enough on there to cool it off? But okay, now I just gotta wait and watch. I'm gonna run to pee. Be right back. Pee break. Listen for the toilet. you guys hear my mad, powerful scream? Because it was. I had to pee real bad. Now I feel much better. Gotta wash these waffles like a hawk, and I gotta get a fork to help get them out. Cause I used all my forks.
Luckily, I just ran the dishwasher
tonight, and I just haven't unpacked it yet. Got me a fork. Ready to go. Oven is on its lowest temperature, so I can take these out, let them cool on a cooling rack, and then put them in the oven to dry out a little bit more. And the ones that I don't eat tonight, I'm going to freeze and save for a later date, because they're even better, I think, after they're frozen and you put them in a toaster oven because they get crispier. The ones I have tonight will be great, but the ones I have tomorrow will be amazing. And the next day, and the next day, and the next day. We'll see how long I get trapped inside with this snowstorm. Thank God I have all gas cooking, and I got propane torch. I can light all my gas stuff. I'll need to cook some stuff that'll go bad in the fridge. Pound of bacon. Hopefully, let's pray the power does not go out. Please, God. Not that I believe in God, but... Oh my God, I got bacon fat all over my computer. Hey, God, do you want to see a recursion? So this chicken sauce you were talking about earlier, you place it in a big bag in the fridge and you soak it. Oh, you soak it in that before you cook it. Okay. Okay, I get it. Maybe. I'm worried about all the sugar that's in that sauce though and it burning, depending on how you cook your chicken, but if it works for you, it works for you. Good on you, Jones. Doom Buggy Jones. The steam smells really good coming out of this, guys. You would not believe. I mean, I hope you would believe. Just gotta be patient. Ooh, it burns. But also, like, hydrating. At the same time. Oh, you're talking about fried chicken doom buggy. Okay, I get you. Ooh, ouch. I'm sorry I picked such a boring food to live stream, guys. I feel kind of shitty about that. Let me show you, though, what I'm planning to film in the next coming days. Because I bought a whole bunch of different candy packs. Try out. I got this one, which is ramen. And then I got Donut Shop, which I'm very excited about. And then I got Ice Cream Shop. The best part is, all the directions are in Japanese, and I don't know Japanese. So this will be extra fun. And on top of Ice Cream Shop, I got the classic, y'all know and love it, burgers. Mm-hmm, hell yeah. And uno mas. Piece de resistance. I got the sushi one. But of course, again, Japanese instructions, so we'll see how that all goes. I don't know. But I'm gonna try my bestest. God, I got lots of film in the next few days. Be a busy bee eating a lot of weird candy treats. How is this going? Okay, a little bit more. A little bit more. I like a little bit more done than that. But we're close. Thank you, Buttercover Baby. I appreciate you saying that the apron is cute. What game am I hoping to play soon? I might play some Overwatch later, or I might just do some strikes on Destiny 2, you know? Just go through the strike playlist. I don't, you know, I'm in a clan, and we used to take it very seriously, and, you know, we would play the raid every week for the first, like, 3 months after it came out, and then we stopped, and just it all fell apart. So I don't really have anybody to play with anymore, so I don't really play that much Destiny. I uninstalled it for a while, but I might try getting back into it. I just realized that I'm wearing my apron inside out. There's a pocket. The pocket on the front, but right now it's on this side. I didn't say there's anything wrong with your name, Buttercover Baby. Alright, I think this is good. We're gonna take these guys out. Oh yes, it feels so good and crispy. Post that back up for a second, let it get heated. Check. Ooh, okay, that's too hot. But check it out. Oh, it smells so good, guys. I fucking love waffles so much. Okay, let's get ready. Don't want to lose too much heat when we open this, so gotta have serving ready on here. Now, to wait another 10 or so minutes, we'll see. Probably not 10 minutes, like five minutes. Buttercover Baby, you want me to say your name so many times?
Buttercover Baby.
There you go. Yeah, we got some nasty perv boys in the chat, apparently. That's okay. I mean, do you. Whatever makes you happy. Next to the Sammy girl, you know. Gotta keep in touch with the fiance, cause she's my lady. And, okay, this is cool enough, I can try one. Everybody's always like, why does Sammy boy have food on his mouth before he starts filming the video? Gotta do this while I cook. Oh, so good. Look at it. Look at that. If you like when people say your name, Buttercover Baby, and want to put your real name out there, wouldn't that be even more of a rush for you? Oh my god. Guys, it's so tasty. Have I watched Game of Thrones? Of course I watched Game of Thrones. And like two seasons behind. Well, I have. And my old housemates from a block away where I used to live for 5-6 years let me use their HBO login still. So I could catch up. I don't know, I kind of lost interest after a while. Maybe I will. Maybe I'll get back into it. County syrup. Dog, these are savory waffles. Have you looked at the title of the stream you're watching? Buttercover Baby, I'm not going to remember to watch your video, so... because it's in the chat, and the chat's going to just scroll up and be lost to time. I'm not going to remember the name Buttercover Baby either. I think if you, like, these names in the chat don't correspond to what the address is on Google anyway, so they're on YouTube anyway. Sorry, dog. But you can tell us about it in here. I know what your food was that you reviewed. Okay, time for these guys to go in the oven, though, and dry out. It's time for Sammy boy to eat a little bacon while he waits. favorite anime? I mean, it depends on the mood I'm in. Like, of course I have, let me show you. I got this dog. Like, Miyazaki, my shit. But I like other things too, TV shows. Sword Art Online, I just watched season one of that recently. That was fun. Today, though, I was mainly watching Steven Universe and got to the point where Hulu ran out of episodes and I got pissed off. I don't watch hentai, so I don't have a favorite hentai. Waiting on these to cook. Alright, we're gonna do these, and we're gonna do one more batch, and I'm gonna make y'all a sandwich. I'm definitely not too pure. That's not the reason I don't watch hentai. It's just I have no interest in it. I'm 29. Yeah, I'm 29 years old. I have a fiance. I mean, Sammy girl. And she's amazing. The way we're interacting with the chat right now, I don't know if I'll leave this one up on the archive. Because it might be weird and make no sense whatsoever to anyone watching it after the fact. Although I guess you can see the chat on the side. We'll see. Do I like marshmallow fluff and Nutella sandwich? Hell no, that sounds nasty as hell. Way too sweet. I'm gonna try to cough off mic over here. Ooh, that's better. What time is it where I live? It is 9:23 right now. Out here on the East Coast, New York City, Brooklyn, y'all. I don't know what that was for, you know. Bedside, do or die. There's nothing to die about, though, really. Well, thank you, Jordan. I hope that was a compliment. I try to be face-to-face with the fans. It's fun to be engaging and do these live streams and be right here with you, you know? When I gesture like this, I'm gesturing over towards the laptop area where I can see your chat. So that's, the laptop is representative of y'all. Have I seen Black Mirror? Of course I have seen Black Mirror. I got Netflix, or my parents have Netflix, and so I have Netflix, because their multi-user system is amazing. Thank you, Netflix, for not caring about people doing that. Like, you could... Oh, this one cooked way more evenly than the last. Super... Oh, that's perfect. Yeah. I mean, I wasn't unhappy with the last one, but... That was fantastic. I guess it's because it's been preheated longer. The metal of the actual, like, slabs in here, the grill here, is more evenly heated. The more you know. Just all comes from experience. Learn as you go. Ain't nothing wrong with messing up, as long as you learn something from it. And those first waffles were messed up. They're a little bit more multicolored and splotchy. Which is I like an interesting complexion. Oh, Buttercover Babies in New York. Where are you in New York? New York? New York City? Or like New York State? Because there's a lot of differences between different parts of New York. Like New York City, even parts of New York City are different. Like people in Staten Island and Queens can be crazy racist hicks or worse off cops. Ugh. And then you go, you know, actual upstate, not like upstate to New York is just like, oh, I went to Westchester. But, you know, that's just Metro North. If you actually go up to, like, Buffalo or something, it's way different. And I've never done that, so I wouldn't really know. I'd like to try sometime, but it just kind of scares me. I come from a place, I come from Missouri. Thank you, Jordan. I do love my food a lot. Sometimes even when it's bad, I love it a lot, so. And I fuck up, everybody fucks up cooking. Nothing wrong with that. But this is good though, so far. I don't think, like, if I got the waffle right, check this out, check this waffle. If I got the waffle right, then the bacon I've already done, that'll be fine. Unless you burn bacon, you're gonna be okay. Lettuce, we have butterhead lettuce, and not gonna do anything to it. Just, you know, shape it enough to put it on the sandwich. And for the tomato, just give it a nice thick slice, so I can't mess up any of those bits, really. I might put on a little bit of Kewpie mayonnaise. No, maybe hot sauce? I'm not sure. But yeah, from here on out, I don't think we can mess it up. A buttercover baby, if you're 1 hour away from the city, you should give me advice on what is something I should go to within, like, Metro North or Long Island Railroad distance of the city to see, because Sammy Girl and I are looking for day trip ideas. And so far I've been thinking of, like, there's an aquarium in Connecticut that I've been to before that I really like and could go to again. There's an aquarium on Long Island at the end of Lure. The Long Island. Does anyone say Lure? I say Lure, and I realize that's probably weird. L-I-R-R. That looks like it might be fun. We've been to Beacon. We've been to Dia Beacon, obviously. I could take her to Poughkeepsie, but what else is there to do other than the pedestrian bridge? I don't know. Oyster Bay? What's in Oyster Bay? Oh, and Jordan, how did it feel making my first ASMR? Silly. Scared. I don't know. I did it because I thought it would be funny. And I wanted to see if I could get more views on YouTube than the magazine I was working for at the time. Which, yeah, I could. They since grew a bit, but I'm trying to show that my one-man band, like, per person versus their, you know, like, 200-man staff. So it was just kind of like a funny challenge that I could do. I was like, oh yeah, I have my own YouTube channel. It's doing better than yours. I'm too fat for beaches right now. It's also too cold, buttercover baby. Enjoying, like, soaking in this smell. It's wafting over here. The rosemary, the thyme, a little bit of sage, garlic. I thought I put in a lot of garlic, but it's not that, it's, I barely even noticed it in the final product, which is nice. It's a subtle garlic. Which to me, like, maybe to you it might be way too much garlic, who knows. I think I might have become desensitized to it. I use so much garlic in my food. I use tons of garlic, and I use tons of shallots. I think it was maybe when I was in college, I was reading a book, Kitchen Confidential, and I think there was a passage where it was like, the main difference between, like, home food and restaurant food that makes restaurant food taste better to you is a shit ton of butter and shallots instead of onions. And I took that to heart, and I started using shallots and everything, and it's amazing. Like, a lot of dishes that I make for myself just start with chopped up garlic, chopped up shallots, and it's usually, like, 5 cloves of garlic and 2 big bulbs of shallots or something. And then, you know, like the other night, I just did that. I put it in a pan with a little bit of oil, but then I threw in soy sauce, some peanut butter, and fish sauce. and then 2 packs of ramen, and I made like a little ramen stir fry. And it was amazing. It jazzed up my $4 of ramen, or maybe $5, $6. They were nice ramen packets, but you know, still, it's ramen packets. It's maximum is like $6. It's very good though. Buttercover Baby, you have a sick ass festival called Oktoberfest. Mm-hmm. Wow, that must be something that's only celebrated there. Ooh, my throat is getting real scratchy. Man, maybe it's sick. Hope not. I'm gonna put these in the oven. Although they are nice and crispy, but a little bit more wouldn't hurt. And as long as I'm over here by the bacon, got a little bit of bacon. You might be wondering, why is my bacon so little like this? Because whenever I cook bacon, I find it's more efficient to fit it in the pan if I cut it in half. So I have, you know, half of a strip of bacon, and I lay out all the halves through the middle, and then a couple halves down the sides of the pan to maximize the usage of the pan. If you use single long strips, they're way too long. You can only do a few at a time. And it's all about using your real estate. And I think this size piece is way better for a sandwich anyway. Oh, oyster fest. Yeah, that sounds great. I love oyster fest. I haven't had oysters in a long time. I remember like the first time, and I could use a second more. I had like oysters as an adult, and I thought I was like adulting so hard. I was like, oh, I'm having raw oysters. I'm so fancy. And I realized it wasn't a big deal. They're good. I think my perception of oysters revolves a lot around whatever alcohol pairing you have with it. But on their own, I usually prefer, like, my... When I was growing up, I used to go to a restaurant called Murray's in Columbia, Missouri, and I would get the oyster po' boy, and it was my favorite thing. And it was like just French bread, fried oysters. They're so good, you know, you got the crunchy outside, the creamy oyster inside, and there's like hot sauce, maybe a remoulade or something on there. And it was delicious, and that's how I loved oysters. I didn't experience raw oysters, I think, until I was in my 20s. And then I had oysters Rockefeller, though, that I was in Connecticut. I was visiting an aquarium up there and walking around a small town and went to a little restaurant. And I remember just, like, I had crab cakes, and we had oysters Rockefeller as a appetizer. And then after dinner, ordered 2 more orders of oysters Rockefeller because I just loved it so much. And then I fell asleep on Metro North back to Grand Central. And then, of course, I had to get on the 7, take it over, and then get on the G to go back to bedside. Let me look at the comments. You guys have been talking a lot. Fried Oreos ice cream. The fried Oreos nasty. Oh, Sammy Girl. Sammy Girl hit me up again with the snap. Y'all can't see this. What if it's inappropriate? Oh, she having mojitos. Good for her. Oh my god, girl. She having fun right now. She having mojitos. I'm jealous. Although I got the acai right here, you know. That's nice. I like a nice light beer. It doesn't mess you up. It can just be nice and relaxing to drink. I don't know. Don't want to overfoam, especially since it looks like, yeah, these are just perfect. match, and then I'll do the rest after you guys are gone.
After I turn off the stream, now that you guys are actually here.
Because I don't want to take up all your time with this boring minutia of just doing batch after batch of waffles. But I do like talking to you. That part's kind of fun. That part's fun for me. It's nice to engage with y'all. See what you like, see what you're into. Especially since I remember, like, back in November where I said, I was going to do a Q&A video, and I got requests from everybody, and then I never filmed it. I probably should do that at some point. I'm going to set this aside. I'll do the rest of that on my own in a little bit. Let's get the bacon out here. And we got a tomato or a tomato, however you choose that sticker off there so I don't accidentally eat the sticker. I've done that before. I'm ashamed to say. And we have, here we go, hydroponic. Got the hydroponic. Butterhead lettuce, yeah. Oh yes. We're gonna need like two, three. I want to get, yeah, that'll be nice. No, let's do four. Let's do four slices of lettuce. That'll be good flavor on that. Good crunch. You want that watery crunch, that's what I'm looking for.
And to top it off,
that Kewpie mayonnaise. Hell yeah. My parents' high school mascot was a Kewpie, which is kind of weird. Their high school was represented by a baby. Raise your hand if you like food. I do. Sorry, open, or do I need to? Oh, I need to take off a little thing on the inside. Oh no, I hate these. Alright. I like that on Kewpie Mayo, they come with, not that I've ever used it, but they have a little star pattern. If you just want to scourge it out of there, you can be decorative with it for, I guess, like deviled eggs or something. Dip waffle in marinara, that sounds nasty as hell. I don't have any marinara right now. I have some pizza sauce that I'm going to use for a pizza in a few days, but not marinara. And I'm not going to waste my good food that I worked hard on with some shitty-ass taste combination. Oh, yes. Yas, queen. So good. Deep fried Twinkies are nasty. Twinkies are nasty on their own. Why would deep frying them make them better? I love that tang the Kewpie has that other mayos don't, because it's more vinegary with that rice wine vinegar in there. Oh, we almost there, fam. We almost got it. Just relax and let it come. What am I squirting in my mouth? It's Kewpie mayonnaise. are you not paying attention, butter-covered baby? This is that mayo. I threw away the other packaging so you can't really see it because it's just like impressed on the plastic. But there's a little baby there. Yeah, I don't think you guys can see that, but that's okay. It's heavy. If you've never had Kewpie mayo, you should go buy some. It might be in the Asian aisle, it might be in the Asian grocery, but it's delicious. It's better than... Well, it depends on what... Like, Hellman's mayo is great, but it depends on what you want to use it for. I like this because it tastes more tangy to me. And it has more rice wine vinegar in it, so that makes sense. And normal mayo does not have rice wine vinegar at all in it, so... Somebody should open a sauna where all the steam is provided by waffles cooking, and then there's like a diner out front where you can eat the waffles. And if you come out from the back from being in the sauna, you already smell like the waffles. You go through your whole day just smelling like waffles, delicious waffles. Alright, people, you gotta watch with the cursing in the chat, because it shows it to me as like, should I hide it or should I show it? And I don't want to have to do all that moderating. Like, I'm busy here cooking. Just use replacement words for your curse words. Do I like candy? Depends on the candy. Like, hard candy? Not really. I mean, it's fine. I don't go out of my way for it, and I don't buy it. Every once in a while, I'll buy a candy bar, though. I guess that's candy. Yeah, Butterfinger. I love a Butterfinger.
Sleepy.
I woke up at like 4:50 this morning because I don't know if you guys saw the live stream I did last night or the food video I made after that. I made very, very spicy quesadillas, and then I woke up very early in the morning and my mouth was still on fire, and I drank 3 16-ounce glasses of water and then realized that was too much for my stomach and I couldn't lay down without wanting to throw up. So I sat in front of the toilet for a while. And then I started having to poop, and I sat on the toilet for like 2 hours, just watching Hulu, and hurting my butt. But I've been up for a long time. I think we're good. Ooh, oh, that's very hot. Oh, yes. Perfect, guys. Okay, I'm gonna unplug this waffle iron. Find a safe place to move it to. Hey, I gotta use a knife actually. I need a knife. And I gotta move this waffle iron without burning anything else. So I need hot pads, which I put somewhere over here. Tomato. There's a better view there. Let's just cut right out the center so you get a nice big slice. We're going to put this in the oven and get one of the drier ones. Nice big slice of tomato. We got our lettuce. We're gonna put our lettuce on the bottom first. I'm gonna save these other two pieces for my next one. So we're gonna go waffle lettuce, bacon, and the lettuce is on the bottom to protect from the moisture of the tomato, obviously. I know you guys aren't dullards. Beautiful. And then on top, we'll have another savory waffle. Put the mayo on this one. Yeah, nice lot of mayo. Another piece of bacon. Look at that. Look at how good that's going to be. Guys, look at this sandwich. Aren't you happy? I'm happy. I'm very happy.
It is so good.
It's like light and healthy, but also fatty and salty at the same time. Thank you guys for watching. I, of course, appreciate your patronage. Please, obviously, I hate to say it, like and subscribe if you're into it. I'll keep doing the best sandwiches and other dishes. You know, I'm not just into sandwiches that I can. Good night, everybody. I appreciate you watching. Because BLT is perfect. Just the acidity of the tomato, the light crunchiness of the lettuce, and then the saltiness and fattiness of the bacon, the savoriness of the rosemary and the pepper, and the crunchy waffle. Oh, guys. Okay, I'm going to go and enjoy this on my lonesome. Although, of course, you know, there's going to be a video up tomorrow. But, again, I appreciate you guys so much. The fans mean everything. Hit like, hit subscribe. Bye! Did I struggle to hit the stream?